It's been a while, guys, but today, it's time for another devlog. Huge updates today, so put your diapers on, get your formula ready, and let's do this. So far, we've made boxing dudes, we can fight, added multiplayer, started over a couple of times, made a free demo, some physics. Everything is looking great, except it's not fun. It's time to tackle the most difficult task so far on this epic game dev adventure. Today we're gonna start putting the single player together and make a boss we can actually play against.
How's it going, everyone? I'm Pontypants. Welcome! I make games.
Yeah.
Okay, here's what I'm thinking. We can move around, we can throw different attacks, dodge, block, all that good stuff. But unless you have a friend to play with, which, I mean, come on, let's be real here, you probably don't.
A game needs a single player mode. Maybe you just want to practice, or perhaps you just like single player games better. I've been gathering references and writing down ideas for a while that I think could be fun for a single player campaign. The tool I'm using for this is called Milanode, who were also kind enough to sponsor this video. Thanks so much for supporting our community, guys. I really appreciate it. For the single player, the idea is that the player will enter leagues of varying difficulty and face off with different bosses and make their way to the top. Each boss will have its own special attacks and weaknesses, so rather than just fighting opponents that just get harder and harder, each fight will be unique and feel more like a boss fight where you have to figure out how to beat it in order to continue to the next stage. I've been using Milanote for about a month now to organize Punch A Bunch, and it's been such a huge help during this process. I am 100% hooked. It's super simple. If I find an image that I like online, I can simply copy it, paste it into my board, write down some ideas, make to-do lists, and so much more. It's easy to move things around, you can stay organized by using different boards, and the sky really is the limit in terms of what you can use this tool for. Anyways, give Milanode a try for your next project. Show this guy some love for supporting the channel. You can sign up for free using the link in the description. I'm gonna keep using it, and I'll show you some more cool stuff I did later in this video.
Okay, here's you. And here is the boss. The problem is, he doesn't move. It just stands there. So how do we make him move and perform attacks and stuff? Yeah, see, that's what I didn't know either, which is why it's been 3 months since the last I vlogged.
Okay, so a few different ways we can do this. One way is using a neural network. It's similar to how your brain works, if you had one.
Enough of the stupid jokes. Please don't unsubscribe.
Neural networks. Similar to how our brains...
You just give the computer some basic things like punch, move, dodge, and give it a goal, which in this case is simple. Win. And then you just let it play against itself over and over, and over time it'll start learning how to play all on its own. In theory.
Which means that I won't have to do anything. I like that. Let's go with that.
You might have already seen this, but a simple example of what I'm talking about here is this browser game by Kiwan, where you put together a creature with bones and muscles, however you want, and its only goal is to learn how to move forward. It will randomly just squiggle around without much success until it finds a pattern that makes it go forward. Sound familiar? It then tries to build upon what worked the last time in an attempt to master the art of walking.
Come on, Toby!
Look!
What?
It's starting to walk upright! Freaky.
So I started looking for a plugin for Unreal Engine that would just automatically teach my boxer how to play.
To my surprise, that doesn't exist.
So, okay, I'll just make this thing myself. I mean, how hard can it be? It's sort of like training a dog, right?
Ziggy, sit.
So I found this thing online with instructions of how to get this thing set up in Unreal Engine. Change of plan, guys. I took a break and I worked on some cool collectibles for the characters instead. Cool cap, straw hat, hey, the official Ponty hat! And something to remember the times by. I'm thinking that each boss will have its own look and clothing, and whenever you beat one, you unlock something. I've also gotten some awesome inspiration from you guys in our Discord server. So much amazing fan art. Speaking of Discord, it's time we put some new additions to our epic pegboard.
Lester's looking a little lonely.
I want to give a massive shout out to our amazing, wonderful, super awesome Discord mods for sticking with me for so long. Glonk, MN Space, Origani.
Welcome to the Epic Pegboard. Oh, and speaking of the Epic Pegboard, did it tell you about the new menu? No? Let's check it out.
I've been secretly working on a new menu for the game since the old one looked like a 5-year-old made it.
Behold, the new Punch a Bunch menu.
The Epic Pegboard is the menu.
What?
Look, look, here you are, in the game. And also, I'm snatching the fan art that you guys are making in the Discord server and I'm putting it up here like little posters and cards and stuff. I just appreciate you guys so much and I wanted to somehow put you in the game as a huge thanks for all your amazing support. So now if you want to be in Punch a Bunch, join the Discord, make some epic fan art, or surprise me with something really cool for a chance to land a spot on the mythical Epic Pegboard. But hey, we still got a boss to make. Clearly, I'm not smart enough to make a neural network, but we could use a state machine. It has a set of tasks to do, it executes them in order, and then around it goes. It works, it's used in most games, but it often ends up feeling a little bit robotic.
Have you seen Armand Kristoff? Don't worry, we'll get him.
But my boy Morgan hit me up on Twitter about some mysterious thing called utility AI, which is supposed to be a little better, and hopefully not too complicated to set up. You give your AI a certain amount of tasks, and it can then score each task based on the situation it's in, and then makes a decision based on the score.
Do you understand? No? Yeah, me neither. Which is why I decided to start with something a little easier, or shall I say, cheesier. Now, pay attention!
What you're looking at is a mouse. Okay, I made it myself, don't judge. To better understand about this AI stuff, I decided to put a bunch of mice in this room that run around looking for cheese.
Okay, easy. But when you eat cheese,
there are certain side effects.
Okay.
But to keep things tidy, we want the mice to go and do their business in this box here. So we need to make sure that the mice start heading to the box before there's an accident. But also, if a mouse goes too long without food, it dies. Oh no! And I'm thinking that this is the perfect scenario to put our new utility AI to the test. The mice will run around looking for food. If it's not hungry enough, but it's needing to go, it'll make the decision to head to the box. But if it's failing to find food, it will prioritize finding food because it wants to stay alive. And this way, the mice will behave a little bit more naturally. To my big surprise, it actually works and it's pretty cool. The mice are able to decide when to go to the box depending on how close to the box they are. If a mouse feels really full, but it's kind of needing to go, but not urgently, it can still decide to swing by the box in case it's close by. And there are a lot of different configurations I can do with this, so I'm actually really happy with this, and I can't wait to try to implement this now into Punch a Bunch and actually apply this to something useful. Well, it was pretty easy to set up the mice. Getting this working for our boxer is going to be a little bit more complicated. First thing was to just get some basics going, like being able to move around the ring. He also needs a way to defend himself, so blocking is pretty essential. So the more you punch him, the more likely he is to start blocking. So if you start mashing him, he's just gonna turtle up. I can also adjust how aggressive or defensive he is, basically whether he'll be more likely to attack or defend. Some bosses in the game will be very defensive, while others will be a lot more aggressive, just to keep things interesting. We also need our boss to look cool, so I took a break and I made this cool bandana for him. I think it looks pretty cool. What do you think? After weeks of figuring this whole AI thing out and almost giving up, ain't gonna lie, I finally had something up and running that was working. What I found really helpful was to first quickly visualize how the AI would work using Milanote and then use that as a reference when building it all up in Unreal Engine. This gave me just a good overview to keep referring back to and to not get lost in the details. Our dude can now lean, move around, block, and fight us back. And the cool thing is that he's using all the same controls we are using. There's no cheating involved. He has all the limitations that you have, which, well, I think is pretty cool. And of course, as all bosses, he also needs to have a special attack, because bosses need to have those. So I made this super epic ground slam animation and these smoke puffs inspired by Breath of the Wild. If you get hit by it, you get dazed and take quite a bit of damage. One thing that might be helpful in a boxing game is to have a health bar. The one we currently have looks like this. I quickly put something a little bit better together that I think matches the style of the game. I'll probably go back and change it later. I'm saving some cool references in this board for the final design, but I think this'll do for now, and I'll keep gathering references as I go. And before I go ahead and actually do the first fight against the AI and get absolutely wrecked, probably, of course I need to put some epic drip on my dude. You know what they say, losing is fine so long as you do it in style, am I right, am I right? And here is the result of 3 months of work for our first epic boss battle.
Ah, he took my thug life!
You wanna knock my thugs off? Eh?
Oh!
Ooh.
Ah! Ooh. Ah! Mm.
It's really difficult right now. I had my friend play it, and all he sent me was this screen grab. I'm guessing he didn't have a great time. I'm really happy with how this turned out, though, because I'm working on this game all alone, and I needed a way to quickly make bosses and not have to program every single battle by hand. So this utility AI system I built is really gonna help me out here. And because I have a really difficult boss setup right now, I can simply pull back on the difficulty and start making more beginner-friendly bosses, and then kind of increase the difficulty as you climb the ranks. If you guys have any awesome ideas for bosses, what they could do and what they would look like, drop a comment below, and if you want to make some fan art, remember to join a Discord community, and I'll put your art in the menu. Make sure it looks good though, hey? And guys, remember to support Milanote for their generosity. Give it a try for your next project. I promise you won't be disappointed. Use the link below in the description to sign up completely free of charge. And of course, if you want to play Punch a Bunch when I release it, head over to Steam and give it a wishlist.
If you want to support the channel, the best thing you can do is simply watch another video. There's lots to choose from, and it really gives the channel that sweet algorithm juice. In fact, just leave a playlist running in the background while you play Fortnite or something, I don't know. Okay, that's it for me. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.